Not after it's already gone.
Jackie, do you have anything else for her to take home?
She took it.
She took it, right?
Yeah.
Grandpa, I might need your help again, just let you know.
Oh, no.
It's not 40 pounds, though.
Is it 5:30?
Yeah.
Okay, so how's everybody doing out there in Cam Land? Oh, wait, Purple. I have Purple. Let's just start out with that.
That was Cam Beetle who was in the house, Jim.
Huh?
That was Cam Beetle who was in the house.
Okay, you got her.
Yeah, she walked out the other
side. Oh my gosh, I was supposed to call her too. Oh my gosh. Give me 1 minute. There's a very important phone call about Save a Rescue that I was supposed to do, and oh gosh, I just didn't do it.
Over there out west, so it's not the same time as you.
Oh, well, that's true. How do you know they're out west, honey?
Because they said that when they called, it was.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Where
okay.
I think it's alive.
All right, just a minute, folks.
Grandma?
Yeah?
You're out of cart room for dogs, starting at the 26 pounds.
26 pounds, you're out of cart room.
There's no green ones in there, Ash?
Correct.
Rose was right at that 25.
Oh.
Do you need these different ones?
Ow.
Do you need to take these different ones? They're just empty.
Hey, Fab, this is Jackie with Friends of Felines Rescue Center. I am so deeply sorry I did not get to call you back earlier.
I'm
going to
get it.
Let me
run
and just give her a hug.
Yeah.
Just because he doesn't need them doesn't mean he can't have them. What?
Bye.
Bye.
Okay. Is he, which one is that? Is that Blueberry doing it?
I have no idea.
Well, who is it?
Somebody screamed again after you went in.
This one's Blueberry. Is that who did it?
I didn't
don't
see.
Know. Okay. Well, look at what we have right here. The three tiger tug of war girls. Yeah. No, sorry, you're a boy. Yeah. Okay, I am so sorry. Thank you, Dark Purple. I'm so thankful that I saw you put that up there about we hadn't heard officially. We have heard officially. And I was supposed to have called her today, and I just didn't. So I called her, apologized, and we'll talk to her tomorrow. Bev is the wonderful person that does the Save a Rescue. And she called last night and left a message that congrats. We did indeed win second place. And I do think that is the 800-pound food, which is wonderful because I checked our dry food, adult food, the other day, and it's about Zippo on the adult. We have some mature, but not the regular adult, so this will be wonderful. So I will talk to her tomorrow, and we'll go from there. But it sounds like we did it, folks, and not we, but you guys all did that. Yeah, 800 pounds of food, and that's a lot. That's all because of your finger power, your finger voting power. Yeah, thank you also very much for putting us up there. So, you know, they're gonna do this again, but what I would really, really like Yes, are we, the top three places, is it just me, is supposed to win, isn't it three of those cat beds? It's so funny, the cats love them, but they squish them down and sleep on top. But they do love those. So they're going to be starting another one pretty soon. And what I would love is not for FFRC to be involved in it. We need to let some other organization be possibly win. And so if you have your favorite cat rescue or dog rescue, now's the time to go ahead and do your voting for them. Not yet, because they haven't started it yet. But yeah, we don't want to do it again for this next one. So that's just being polite of us. But we did win second place, and I'm very, very grateful. Yeah, that was a lot of punching power and getting through that. What is that thing where you have to caption thing? Yeah, I drove everybody crazy. So thank you, everybody. I'm trying to be a good girl. I learned it from you, Dark Cat. So, oh, North, you are so sweet. Oh, North, you are just so cute. That's so sweet. All right, well, let's get busy, because my time is running out here before Steve and I leave. And as you can see, Hannah and her mama, Connie's here. They're going, and I wouldn't be able to go if it was not, especially, or actually for a lot of people. Connie is going to take care of my mom, which I would not even consider going unless Connie helped take care of my mom. Mom's comfortable with Connie, and that says a whole lot. And then Hannah will be here to help with the kitties and the doggies, because they're already whining at her. And then Connie D will be in tomorrow night to do medicines, and she will then be in Wednesday morning to do breakfast. So and then the volunteers will be filling in on all the places. So I'm gonna go and just kind of chill out for a couple days, and I'll be calling in though to make sure everything's okay. All right, so is Mudgy on? Is Mudgy our cat-a-terry? Mudgy, Mudgy. I thought I heard somebody. Where? Can you hang on a moment? Hello? Yeah. Okay. Did it already, man? Yeah, I'm almost positive. Oh gosh, I don't know. Yeah, I don't know. But I think they, I'm not positive. But I think that they did. I'm not positive. That's what I thought. Yeah. Okay. Okay. All right. Thanks. I will. Thank you. All right. Bye-bye. This is Kiara. So I don't know where my girl is, but we're going to carry on. So Mudgy is... There's Mudgy. Okay. This one is from Amazon. Doesn't have a name on the outside. Oh, I have to look every single month. Oh my gosh. Zula, thank you. We love our baby food. I think probably of all the spittage I've had spit back at me from the kitties. I've probably eaten a whole jar of this in my lifetime. Thanks to the kitties. Thank you, Zula. Appreciate this very much. Yep. We will rotate just in case Mary's on. We'll be good. Good girls. Come on, you go on. Come up. I think we'll throw in the office and let Lynette deal with them. She'll break them down tomorrow. And this might be a good one for Catathon. And this one is from Kiko, our good friend in California. And I hope Kiko gets to come and visit us again. Oh, Kiko, you told me about this. This is to make a large open-faced kitty sandwich. Oh my gosh, it's a piece of bread. Oh my gosh. Kiko, you're a nut. This is cute. Boy, is that soft too. And that feels like memory foam. Kitties are gonna love that. Yeah, we could do a little zipper thing here and let a kitty crawl in there. We'll have to put this up. Honey, maybe you could, would it fit on a Coronda tower? Okay. Thank you, Kiko. That's really cute. Yep, a kitty sandwich. Heads up, guys. Well, this one goes the back door. This is Kiko's too. And Kiko's on. Oh, that's nice. That helps. This is the yummy box, isn't it? Yeah. I think you heard Mary's call for Bonito Flakes and Pania's call. There's three bags. I think I had someone else say they might send some in too. And it's fine with us because we go through a lot of this now. We have a lot of kitties addicted to this. Thank you, Kiko. Very, very wonderful. You know, I wonder. My jar over there is going to need a refill, too, already. This is, please give one bag of the Bonito Flakes for Elizabeth, Canto, and Sir Oric. I can send that tonight, probably with Angie. Oh my gosh. Kiko, is this somebody you know, or did that get in there by accident? It's a little baby with a teddy bear. Let me know if that got in there by accident, because I can send that back. Or whoever that is awfully cute. And, oh wait, 18 cans of, these are the beach clip. These are yum. These are good with peanut butter and jelly. No. Slap a sardine in the middle of it. Got a good sandwich. We could try one. I have to get her meds to her too. Kiko, thank you. Boy, look how long his legs are. I know, you're fine. You're fine. Quit acting like a baby. There he goes. Hmm, Hensley's in there. Well, he probably should come out of there too. Go on, here they are, peeps. So you might have noticed the lady that was just in. She's going to adopt Declan. So that's an, that, well, I have to do one more check on her, on her vet. But I'm pretty sure she's going to be able to adopt Declan. Oh, this is from PJ. Look at this. When it rains, it pours. Good things like bonito flakes. Look at this. Thank you. This is PJ and Bad Kitty. Thank you so much. Now we don't have, nobody has to worry about running out of bonito flakes. Thank you, PJ. Give Bad Kitty a pet from me. That stuff stays forever. It stays until we need it. You okay now, buddy? You're all right. Yeah. Thanks, PJ. And I think I'll just stuff this stuff in, and we'll just throw these in to the mail room then. Heads up, guys. And we have also Mudgy. Oh, yeah, I have one other thing here, too. From Elaine and Alan. Elaine and Alan B. from Florida. I always have a hard time reading this. They sent us, these are the box, they're very heavy, so I know Elaine and Alan doesn't care if we open them so we can get them put away. They sent us, it's three cases of Friskies. Four cases of Friskies. Wait a minute, Mudgy. Mudgy, hang on. Let's do it this way. Three cases of 24-pack Friskies. One case of 32 Friskies. And then Fancy Feast. One box of Fancy Feast. And also one box of appetizers. So, there you go. Thank you, Elaine and Alan. And they do this every single month for us. And it really, really puts a nice thing there on our food shelves. So thank you, Elaine. Thank you, Alan. And then, you know, sometimes when you guys hear that we're low on something, you guys really super duper help us on that. And Lan also sent four bags of Bonito Flakes. And she had told me in her email that if we really, really needed them, that we could go ahead and open them. And I had to laugh because behind me was her box, and the cats were in the box. They had jumped down from the Coronda Tower beside it onto the box and right in. And I could hear them doing something, but I wasn't sure. I was busy, and I just was only half listening. And then I turned around, and there they were. It was Dandelion and two of her kitties were in the box. So, Lan, we rescued your Bonito Flakes, and I appreciate it. We do not have to worry about Bonito Flakes now for a while. So, thank you. And then we have two more boxes here. And these are, you know, today is Coralie's birthday. Did you all know that? Today's Coralie's birthday. And this is, these two boxes are in honor of Coralie's birthday. And it's from Donna B's cat. And Donna B is from Georgia. So Donna B and her cat sent these from Georgia for our Coralie. Honey, do you know where our Coralie is?
She's in her cubby.
Oh, she's in her cubby. Oh.
Jackie, can I start the dryer?
Yes. Yeah. Yeah, but maybe put the stuff in the washer into the dryer with it. Yeah, thank you, honey. Coralie's gonna get two new beds. And I know where these are gonna go. She She's right now in the cubby back there. Connie's with her. This would be awesome. Donna, thank you. This would be awesome in her little cubby. There she is. And look, it matches her.
Cornelia. We got two.
This one would be perfect in her purple bed down there. Look at that. I happened to come across her picture the other day of when she came in, when she had all four of her legs and her tail and her ears, and she was skinny. Kind of got me how bad she was. You kind of forget, you know. I guess you just want to think of the good, not the bad. Look, she always looks like she smiles.
We'll do something later.
Yeah, today's your birthday. This is from Donna B and her kitty. We'll put these, do you want to put this in her cubby?
Okay,
on top of whatever's there, she'll find it. All right. You like it, don't you? Thank you, Donna B. from Georgia. You've made her day. Yeah, five. It's just incredible, isn't it, Mudgy? Now, can I put you here? And we have one more box for you. Stay right there. I'll never let you drop. This is for you, too. You think you're pretty cool, don't you? And you are. Kitties are going to have some paper to play with. Oh my goodness gracious. Connie, you see that? Wow. Oh, honey, you will never, ever, ever, oh my gosh, you will never have to want for a cushy again. These are, whoops, is there some goodies in here? Oh, and look at, this is your fave of all fave. Oh, she says, I know what that means. She's rubbing on the box. I thought there was two. There is. Look at this. You got two of them. Oh, she likes it. She likes it, Donna. All right. Talk me into it. And we don't have to worry so much anymore because she's certainly not a little chunky at all. Here. Thank you. She's happy. And look at this, what else Donna and her kitty sent. So we have two beds, three, four, five, six, seven, eight beds, one for each foot and one for two ears and one for two cheeks. Thank you, Donna. We'll share these out with everybody. We could take these out of the plastic so they don't slip inside so much. You want to?
Oh, really? Cool.
Thank you. Thank you, Donna. Sometimes our cushies, well, I know that the middle of these get so thin, it's like, you know, laying on a pillowcase. Yeah, there you go, girl. And we have some envelopes, too. I'm going to put this picture up here in case we need to send that back to Kiko. Here, there's some more. Hi, Dawn. This one is from Velma T. from Canada. Thank you, Velma. There we go. Aren't those soft? And those wash and dry so nicely. Oh, Velma, thank you. This is for Catathon help. And Mudgee, will you mark that for Kenneth on help? And then, Mudgee, we'll have to check and make sure Velma's name is on that list that we use for Catathon. Oh, thank you, Velma. And remember, that will be quadrupled. And then this is from our Wanda friend, our portrait lady Wanda. Can I set those there? Oh my gosh. Wanda, you are so nice. This is a certificate by Wanda. And it says, please use this gift certificate for a raffle or auction or flash sale or whatever is needed. If it's a graphite portrait, it's worth $125. If it's a color portrait, the value is $200. Wanda, this is really, really cool. Really nice of you. $125 if it's a graphite. Value in $200 if it's color. Okay, Wanda. Thank you, Mudgee. I worry about stuff like that, as you know. Connie, can I give this to you? And will you put on here, because I won't be here tomorrow, Lynette, please speak for Jackie. Yes. Okay, and then put it under her desk flap.
Whoops! Didn't mean to knock
you. Aww. Come here. How are you doing, Dawn?
Good, how about you?
Yeah, okay. And, oh boy, I tore that up.
Here?
Whoops, I kind of messed that up.
Oh, Coralie, you got a bed that matches you.
Isn't that pretty?
What was the thing that was last week? I don't know.
This is an application form. For possibly Breezy. But you know, there's a lot we have to do on this. We always check that references and all that. Hey, Dawn, will you take that I Love Cats one there on the upper right? Hey, don't do that.
Hey, Hensley.
And stick this up there, and then I'll start working on that one. Yeah, can you reach?
How about we use a doggy?
Okay. Hensley's been a little bit of a cranky boy lately.
Can we put you in Dodger's pen? Oh, you were cranky last week.
Yeah, we put that in the mailroom.
Oh, I mean, Saturday he was cranky. Sorry.
He didn't get enough holding time today, I guess. And this is from Joy D from New York. Did you approve of it? Huh? This is from Joy D from New York. Oh, my gosh. Oh, what a beauty. Is it okay? It says, Jackie and our FFRC family, thank you again for all you do. We so look forward to your blog to know what is going on. Please use this gift for the FFRC needs. Also, we enjoy your thank you notes, but they do take time and money from the kittens. So if you would like to stop, we understand. This is from Don and Joy. Don and Joy D. You are so sweet. Know that we treasure the memories of our past visit. With love, Don and Joy D. And their kitties are Camor, Scotchy, Stitches. I think it's Ashley and Ziva. Do me a favor. Will you take a posting note and just write no thank you note, and then stick it on there for me? Thank you, sweetie. Thank you, Joy. Thank you, Dawn. I appreciate that. Uh-oh.
I know.
Kitties are starting to cry.
Do I need to round them up and put them in their underfeed, or?
Well, or just feed them down. They're kind of doing good. The little ones, the littlest ones are all in the back now.
Yeah, that's all good.
Yeah. And this is from Melissa L. And Melissa is from New York. And Melissa is very faithful in sending us something. Just like clockwork. Melissa, thank you. I appreciate you. And then our last one is from Susan W. in New Jersey. Susan W. in New Jersey. Kitties.
I know. I'm slow, aren't I? Sorry.
That sounded really pathetic, didn't it?
And then they look up at me.
You poor kitties. Sue and Ed, thank you. They sent, I think, like five of the Prina weight circles. It says, come on, does it really matter what it says in here? My hubby and I really enjoy watching the cam and appreciate all you do for the kitties. I've enclosed coupons, Prina circles, and $5 chicken money for Derecho and friends. I'm a lurker mostly. Chat name is Susie Pat. Oh, I know Susie Pat. I recognize your name. Have a wonderful summer. Hugs, Sue and Ed, and their cats are Lucy and Charlie. So we have a chicken $5. We used four of the chicken $5 today. And they also sent some coupons. Oh, for broth and appetizers. Thank you, Sue. Thank you, Ed. And we'll put this in the chicken fund. And
you want me to put this?
Oh, I'll take it, that one then. And then Hannah, could you put this in that white, that clear tub that's right behind you? Thank you, sweetie. Okay. That is it, what we have, and I'll just give you a few updates. The kitties are all doing really well. You know, we had a little bit of spell last week of that diarrhea and vomiting from, we think, spoiled chicken.
Ooh, that's good.
What was that? It was intense.
So that Monday night was the start of it?
Yes.
Oh.
It was intense. And then as soon as we, like probably even 4 or 5 hours after we got rid of that and didn't give any more, and then we started them on a couple thickeners, it got a lot better real quick. Metronidazole too. So, excuse me, sorry. So they're all doing really well. Isabella Bird has a tiny little bitty little cold in her eyes, but she's okay. And then tomorrow, Steve and I are going to go. We're going to leave as soon as I can get done with breakfast. Probably about 8:15, because I got to do a couple other little things too before I go. But as soon as I can, 8:15 I'm shooting for. We're going to take off and go to Shipshawana. And oh yeah, and
it's the two hottest days.
I know. It's gonna be hotter in blazes. Oh, you know what? We have those things here. I could take two of those. Get out of the fridge. Where are those things? Okay. I had some neck things, but now I opened the door. Yeah. I opened the door and now she wants a piece of chicken.
Oh, I know.
Here, you gotta get out of the refrigerator though.
Here, kiss me.
Follow
your nose. Follow your nose.
Go on.
Yeah, they smell the chicken.
Here. I'll give them just a tad bit of the. Oh my gosh, look at them, Dawn.
They're gonna want my slop
oh
now.
Oh my gosh, they're after my beanie.
Actually, you can touch the cheat bag and she'll be right behind you begging for
it. Aw, they know. Oh, look behind you even. Did you guys miss out on 10 meals today? There, oh my gosh, I think I made just a big mess, Dawn, I really did. I'm sorry.
Is that cheese?
Yeah.
Oh.
I didn't know what to grab.
Chicken sauce.
So, yeah, they're all crying, they're hungry. Very hungry.
They're growling.
And growling.
Oh, boy.
So we made it through this weekend of four concession events and our surgery. And then Tuesday was our other surgery. And getting ready for catathon, I think, has just about done us in this week. It's been a busy, crazy time. So then this Friday night, we're going to have Ashlyn, you know, my granddaughter's getting married. And Saturday, and we're going to have the rehearsal dinner out here. They wanted pizza, and we're going to just use the shelter house for all of the family, both sides of the family, and whoever's involved in the wedding party will come out. And then Saturday is her wedding, so we're very excited about it. So on Shipshe, we're going to tomorrow do the flea market, and then Wednesday we'll do all the in-town, those quaint little stores that they have. We're going to do that. So we had a lot of great people helping between the concession and helping us with the post-ops for surgery. Was a lot of different volunteers and a lot of help. And a lot of good feedback too, I think, from the community. So I just wanted to give you a little update too about what happened this weekend. I don't have all the pieces of the puzzle put together yet. Oh, Mary, you probably should probably do that. That would be a good idea. That way you don't get, your car will be safer. So you all know what happened this weekend. I don't want to go into all that. But and we don't have all the pieces of this put together, but I'm finding out more and more of what happened. While we were having surgery Saturday, I got a phone call from the power dam bar down here, and I didn't catch it. I didn't even know it was there until in the afternoon, and they called and said about a stray dog that was down there. I didn't think too much of it, because as they continued to talk, they said that they then just kind of shoo-shooed the dog away, and it was heading down towards our area. So, you know, I was so busy that day, I didn't see it. And then we had that tragedy then Sunday morning early, and then I found out that some of our mods and viewers had seen a dog looking into the cabana through the screen, and it was a yellowish type dog. What I had done then, I made up like 45 flyers, and we passed them out to all of the neighbors up and down the road, both sides. See, we don't have neighbors behind us at all. It has to go this way. And just explaining of what happened, to please, please keep an eye on their cats so that the same situation wasn't repeated with their cat. And that if they have a dog that was at large, to keep it under control, because if it came down here again, it would be put in doggy jail at the shelter. So after we passed out these, I got probably four phone calls from people. Hi, Angie.
Hello.
Probably four phone calls from people who had seen the other dog, the black dog. And so I don't know, my mind, sorry. To make a long story short, what we did last night was Steve stayed out up and he went outside very often as soon as it got dark to 1 o'clock. And then 1 o'clock to 4 o'clock, Connie D came over and she sat out there. And then tonight, Barb is gonna come back and sit 11 to 1, and then Faithy's gonna come back from 1 o'clock to 5 o'clock to help me get through breakfast. Because what I did this morning, about every 20 minutes, I went out, took my big bag of cans and shook it. I'm probably sure that they heard it down a mile away, but I thought if there's a dog around, we're gonna scare the heck out of it. So we made it through last night without any problems and without even seeing the dog. I had my big dog trap set, but nothing was found. So then we found out today that there were indeed two dogs. And they were not drop-offs as what we originally had thought. They took off and ran away from home about a mile and a quarter down the road. The one dog got back a little bit sooner than the fat black dog, but they did do other damage on their way back home. They did kill some other animals, and that's how it all came to be, was that it was just all a tracking type of thing. So he's already been, what do you call it when you give him a ticket?
Citation.
He's already been cited for one animal for sure, and probably two will be coming up shortly from ours. And then there'll be another one too, I believe. Minimum. So I feel kind of safe tonight because both of those dogs are now back home and under lock and key. But just in case, Barb and Faithy are still coming out tonight. And if we get through tonight without spotting anything else, then we won't continue our night watches anymore after tonight. So one of those reasons why you don't let your dog run at large.
We had neighbors that had chows when we first moved in, and they cornered a coon one night against they got out of their fence, but it was, they cornered it against the fence, and they just went all night long till it.
Yeah. We can't get them back, but I'm gonna do something here in memory of them. I haven't quite figured it out yet, but I will do something here that will be in honor and memory of them. And you know, Mudgy, they do. They felt horrible when they were confronted by what happened by the dog warden. We have a really good dog warden right now, and she tackled this head on, and just by piecing everything together, you know, kind of the story more and more came together. So we'll do something. I'm not quite sure what we're going to do, but we will do something. And they did, and you know, feel bad for them too. That wasn't their intent with their dog to have that happen. So, and he acknowledged whatever came to him because of his dogs. He was not going to fight it, that he would step up and try to take care of the matter. So I have to give him credit for that. know, we can't change it, and so we'll.
So send this one out, or send this one in?
We'll just do something extra nice in their honor, and Jolene's honor. I know, part of me is really, really angry and mad, and part of me is like, I can't change it, and I'm not a negative person, and I can't dwell on stuff like that. I never do. I never have been, and we'll just go on, and this too shall get better. It would be really, really difficult to fence in that porched area, Deb. It just would be so difficult. I mean, it would have to be everything, including the driveway, and boy, to undo that all the time, just, it would not be feasible. But you know, all this time that we've been doing this, we've never have had this happen before. So we're just going to carry on, and you know, I'm not a dweller on these things, so we just have to look forward to what's going on. There's a lot of joy here, a lot of babies here, a lot of good cats here, and we're just going to keep on going and see how everything goes, and it'll be fine. I know I was sorry for Sherry. My order of things when we have something happen is I first tell the volunteers on our volunteer page. I cannot individually call that many people, so we purposely set up our volunteer page, and I just hope and pray everybody always sees that quickly. And then my second order of business is to inform the mods, and a lot of times the admins, and then I do the blog. But I feel always it's necessary to always let the volunteers know, and the other people like our mods who help you folks.
What?
Yeah, we tried some of them in the Kobe, and they did not like it. No. Who is December? Wait a minute. We changed the name. Who is December? Oh gosh, Mudgy, my brain is like sog right now. Angie.
Yeah.
Do you remember who that is, December? What cat was that, December, just this last weekend?
What? I'm sorry, for what?
A cat here, December. December is that cat's name that got away from us. Oh,
Humane Ohio.
Mudgy, I'm sorry. There has been so much happened since Tuesday.
I'm like, I don't know what
you're talking about. Well, gosh, boy, but I knew I remembered the December name. No, December is the spay that got away. We have not seen. That was a little sore thorn in my side a little bit, because it was left to believe that we had something to do with that cat getting out of the cage, and we did not. That cat came here with the cage door, crate door not latched. But, you know, we've explained that. The owner knew it, everything. It was just a really weird crate. But we have not seen that cat. We have passed out 32 or 34 posters on December. And thank you, Zula. And I have not seen her at all. And I still feel that she'll turn up, because the neighbors really don't have outside cats. We just really don't see outside cats around here. So it's got to come back here to eat. It just has to. Oh, thank you, Shona. Thank you, Faithy. And Deb, yes, your pop-up was A+ perfect for this weekend. Yeah. All right, well, folks, I'm gonna head in there and help my mom. From Nance, who are you talking? Is that a question for me? No, Sakine, right? Is the cat that came in actually with the name of Clinton because he was injured. He was hit by a car on Clinton Street. And we named him Sakine. And Mudgy, you're going to have to tell me if I really botched that name up. Yeah, that's the new tripod. And he is doing really, really well. I think that's where Zelda must be in my suitcase. Is she on my desk?
Nope.
She must be. I would take her. December is the cat, yeah, the tortie tiger that escaped. All right, you guys all take care. I will do breakfast in the morning. And then I'm gonna bug out. I get to look for something extra cool to bring home. Don't know what it is yet, but I'm gonna look. Oh, and I do also remember we have Steve and I will go to the Amish wind chime place, and we get to pick out a wind chime to hang outside where Trucker is. So, can you imagine if I didn't, KB? They'd be having a bonito party all night. Thank you, everybody. Hey, and so I just want to say a thank you, too, for trying to keep an extra eye out for the dogs, the two dogs that were loose through the windows. I appreciate you doing that. I do feel that they do have the two dogs that were loose, but like I said, we're going to continue watch yet tonight. But thank you for being so helpful on that. We are low on, this is from what Mary found out on Friday, baby food, appetizers and broths, kitty snackers, baby wipes, paper towels, and Clorox and Lysol wipes. Wow. Baby food, appetizers and broths, kitty snackers, baby wipes, Clorox and Lysol wipes, and paper towels. You are indeed, Joe Bear. And I felt that all day today and yesterday. Thank you. Sakine. Is it Sakine? Mudgy, do I have that right? Let me know, Mudgy, if I'm saying that right. He's a skinny old boy yet. We've got him down as about a 2-year-old, I think. Thank you, Joey. Thank you for the paper towels. Thank you. All right, folks. I will see you all later. Somebody's crying.
There's food in front of
here. You. Here, he says, remember I was so sick. Now I need special food.
You got special food. What you did. I want
my cancer. I see a bare spot on the dry food.
It's tragedy.
Yeah, it's a bare spot.